Judges chapter. Chapter 7. And can you help myself, these adult women ushers, don't they just look magnificent this morning? Amen. Judges chapter 7, I want to focus on that underscore, pin on laser, precision, verse number 10. Judges chapter 7. As we continue our walk, Judges chapter 7. The New Living Translation says, but if you are afraid to attack, go down to the camp with your servant, Pure. Repeat these words after me. But if you are afraid to attack, I want you to put a big smile on your face and look at your neighbor, look them dead in the eye and say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor, too scared to be blessed. Look across the room at somebody and smile at them now. Smile at them, no frown. Say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor, I didn't come to bother you. I didn't come to stir your Kool-Aid. But I hope you're not too scared to be blessed. Wonderful God, in Jesus' name, thank you, bless you, God. Stand as an empty vessel before a full fountain. It's preaching time, God. Come on, God. Bless your people. Help your preacher. In Jesus' name. And all God's children said, amen. Pa, can I be brutally honest? And Joanne, can I be brutally honest? Daryl, can I give it to you straight? No chasing. Some of us are too scared to be blessed. Some of us do not possess the boldness of God to be blessed by God. So some of us are too afraid to move to the next level of God. Angelo, some of us have resigned ourselves to be satisfied with the status quo. Some of us are frankly too weak-minded to believe that God can change our lives. Some of us, Rosetta, are so mean that we make it difficult for God's love to penetrate our heart. Some of us are just too darn scared to be blessed by the best. Look at your neighbor, look at that, and I say, neighbor, oh neighbor, are you one of the ones that are too scared to be blessed? I wonder, do I have any bold believers in this space? Bold believers that are bold enough to take it back. Somebody shout, take it back. Everything that the enemy has tried to steal from you, everything that the enemy has tried to swindle from you, everything, every stressful night that the enemy convinced you to waste your time, every ounce of joy that the enemy robbed of you, I declare and decree that I am taking it all back. I refuse to allow anybody to chase me away from my destiny. I am not too scared to be blessed. Our given our selected portion of the sacred text for examination is housed in the book of Judges. The book of Judges aims to supply the reader with the history of Israel after the conquest of Joshua and before the monarchy of the kings. The ebb and flow of the book of Judges is that Israel does evil. God sends an enemy. Israel cries in distress. God sends a judge to deliver. And Israel again does evil. And the cycle repeats itself. Last week, our character Gideon was getting ready for the fight. The narrator used his new name, which said to us that something different was about to happen. We discovered last weekend, Ruth, that God will give you moments of refreshing. We discovered your enemies are there to teach you a lesson. We discovered everybody, Pat, can't fight with you. And we also discovered God wants to reveal God's power to us. Now, the narrator says to us that on the same day, the very same night, Yahweh notifies Gideon that the fight
should commence immediately, and that the campaign had already been awarded to him before one punch had been thrown. The text indicates that Gideon is still too scared to fight after all that the Lord has done. The text indicates that Yahweh advised Gideon that if he was still too scared, then go down to the enemy line and eavesdrop on the scuttlebutt being discussed. The text indicates that Gideon and his homie tiptoed down to the line and heard the perimeter guard talking about a dream. The text indicates that the interpretation of the dream was that God had given the enemy into the hands of Gideon. The text indicates that Gideon was strengthened by what he had heard and was now ready to execute the battle campaign. The text indicates that Gideon worshiped. The text also indicates that Gideon went back to his troops and advised them, get up, for God is ready to hand the Midian army into your hands. Beloved, it's obvious. It's obvious that you're away from the text that Gideon was too scared to be blessed by God. The victory, Mr. Hubbard, was already awarded, but this chosen vessel was too scared to fight. Come, sit with me for just a few minutes and let us see if the text gives us any answers as to why Gideon and perhaps somebody listening to me is too scared to be blessed. Y'all ready? Perhaps first of all, Gideon never learned how to win. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor or neighbor. Did you ever learn how to win? Oh, I wish I had. Somebody look at the text. Look at the text in verse number 9b. God has already given him the victory. Now, check it out. Last week, we saw that God had already given him the victory. Two weeks ago, Armstrong, we saw that the Lord had already given him the victory. What is it, Rosetta, about victory that Gideon doesn't comprehend? Could it be that Gideon never learned how to win? Could it be that Gideon never knew how to recognize victory? Could it be that I have some listeners in this place who are just like Gideon? You are so accustomed to defeat that you never learned how to win. Are you so oppressed that you cannot recognize liberation? Perhaps the real truth is that you, like Gideon, have never been liberated from your past. I think I said something. Look at your neighbor, and tell your neighbor, get liberated from your past. You see, your past has you on lockdown. Your past has you messed up. Your past has you stuck on stupid. Your past has you in prison. Be liberated from your past so that you will be able to proceed to your destiny. God wants you to win. God wants to liberate you from your past. In fact, the New Testament writer declares, thanks be unto God that giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Look at your neighbor right now, if you're bold enough, and tell your neighbor, I got it. I got it. with scared language.
Look at your neighbor. Say neighbor. Oh neighbor. Are you sure? You heard me right? Look at the text. Look at the text in verse 13 and 14. Fear. Identified with fear. I'm trying to help somebody. What language? What language can you identify with? Look at it in Ruth. Throughout our study, and Ruth, I want you to find one time. Can you show me in Ruth one time when Gideon gets excited? Look at it, Jackie. Look at what excites Gideon. Gideon got excited over the language of defeat. His ears heard what was already in his heart. I wish I had some help in here. You see, faith and fear cannot coexist. You see, this is one of the things that is wrong with our political conversations. We have the right and we have the left. Those on the right run to those networks that reinforce their own ideology. And those on the left do the same thing. No one wants the truth anymore. We only want to be told that in which we want to hear. Gideon was too scared to be blessed because he could only identify with the scared language. Help me understand. Help me understand. Somebody help me understand why he was not scared to creep down to the enemy line, but he was too scared to attack. Somebody help me. Help me. He was not afraid, Rosetta. He was not afraid, Kala, to get close to the enemy, but he was afraid of fighting when the victory had already been won. Apparently, he resisted faith language. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor. Do you speak faith language? Somebody listen to me. You need to be transformed because you will never be blessed until you learn how to talk faith language. Pastor, what is faith language? I don't know what faith language is, Pastor. Can you help me? Yeah, I'm going to help you out. Y'all ready? This is straight no chaser. This is faith language. I am blessed. I am highly favored. I am healed. I am set free. I am delivered. I am chosen. I am divinely made. I am the head and not the tail. I am liberated. I am more than a conqueror. Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, you better learn how to use your faith language. Faith language says no weapon formed against me shall prosper. You better learn how to use your faith language. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall? You better learn how to use your faith language. When my enemies came upon me, but they stumbled. You better learn. You better learn. discipleship time. Discipleship time, it's recruitment time. It's not about membership, but it's about discipleship. We want to offer Christ to you, but can I help you? Do you mind? Do you mind? I got somebody online. I need to help them. The text says that the enemy was so vast and so large that it was like sand. You couldn't even count the sand. And I got somebody listening to me that it seems like you have more enemies than you have friends. Somebody listening to me, and it seems like you're under siege. But I want you to know, God is faithful. God has already, somebody say already. Keep saying it already. Already enjoy.